to transfer the very, very special Ystad Jazz Festival spirit to all of you. Thank you also to everyone who has and is supporting the festival by buying a donor ticket. It's very valuable for the association here to feel and experience your support. Thank you very much for that. Behind me, we have a wonderful string quartet who, together with Fredrik Lindborg and his team, will transfer the spirits of Swedish jazz to you. Very much welcome again.
Är den på? Ja, det är den. Hej, välkomna. Just det. Daniel just reminded me. I was told to speak English. And to be honest, I'm a bit stressed over that. Because my friend here, the behind here, he used this as a party trick to make me speak English because it's so funny. so my confidence is very low. Well, however, I will try. The first tune they played him, it was Mazurka by Lars Gullin. He was a baritone player, if you don't know that. It was called Mazurka, and it was a mazurka, wasn't it? Yeah, that's a kind of style, I guess. After that, we played Holy Grail, also, of course, by Lars Gullin. The next tune is titled Galium Verum, and that's Latin. Do you want to do your... we have a poet in the band. You haven't tried it in English, but your pronunciation is very good. Do you want to try your... It's a haiku. She wrote a haiku. It's a kind of a Japanese poem. We had a game. And it's very complicated how you should make the poem. Okay, but let's try it.
So the title of the song is Galium Verum. Galium Verum. Blommande harmonier, Gulmåra Gullin.
And Galium Verum, Gulmåra in Swedish, is a kind of yellow flower growing on the island of Gotland, I guess. Okay, here it is, Galium Verum.
Thank you.
Okay, thanks. I don't know really what to talk about. I don't talk at all, I think. We're just gonna play the next one. And it's inspired by The Wizard. A very soft and beautiful tune named after the wizard Merlin, so it's called Merlin.
Thank you.
Thank you. It was beautiful, wasn't it? I thought so too. Sorry. We're going to play another tune, a very uncommon Lars Gullin tune. I haven't found any recording with Lars himself. We have realized that there's a text to it written by the famous Swedish, what is it called? I have a help here. Lyricists, very complicated word. And his name is Cornelis Vreeswijk. And Ylva Lee, you read something about this tune yesterday. What did you find out? Cornelis was Dutch. Do you want the microphone?
Yes.
I know the title, and I can translate it into English as well. It's called "I min smala sväng" på svenska, and it's "In my narrow bed." But did you read anything about what it's about? Is a kinky text or okay? Okay. I heard once that it was for a children's TV show, but Ylva Lee says that it doesn't decent at all. So probably it wasn't. Or maybe it was. It was the 70s, so everything was okay. okay, here it is. In my narrow bed. Thank you. late date. I never thought about what it meant, actually. I thought it was late that you meet someone and go to a restaurant and drink wine and flirt and things. But is it that really? Late date, or is it datum in Swedish? Aha, Danny thinks it's about meeting someone late in life, maybe. I don't know. However, the next tune is on the same theme, I think. It's called Fine Together. Den här var det. Nej, förbaskat. Yes, Swedish, English. yes. Well, I don't really know what to say about the next tune, but I know this. It's called Ma, and that's a name. We thought it was maybe some initials or something like that, but it's actually a name. Ma, and she was a nurse taking care of Lars Gullin. His wife, Maj-Lis Gullin, told us that, actually. And, well, it's kind of a sad tune, and is it maybe a little bit classical, maybe, in its appearance? It's very romantical. Romantic, okay, yes. It's not really jazz. Oh, some of it is. However, he had Lars Gullin. He was, of course, a jazz musician, but he was also, I think he was a classical piano player, wasn't he? Maybe I'm lying now. It was true, yes. He studied at the Conservatory of Stockholm, classical piano and the composition, I think. And he wrote lots of tunes, great tunes, and some of them were a bit classical. Is that how do you pronounce it? Classical. And some was inspired by the Swedish folk music as the first one. This is a bit classical. It's called Ma, after the nurse. I was reminded to inform you that we have made a record actually with these tunes, and it was supposed to have a big release concert in Stockholm Concert Hall actually, but because of Corona and everything, this is maybe the official release. I don't know when it is, but we have a record, both LP, a double LP, and CDs. And I realized I should present the band so I don't forget about it. Sabina Sandri Olsson on the cello. And next to her, Ylva-Li Siljakos-Sillen. Henrik Naimark Meyers on the violin. And also on the violin, Daniel Migdal. On the drums, Daniel Fredriksson. And on the bass, Martin Sjöstedt. I used to tell you the arrangers of the tunes. The tunes are written by Lars Gullin, as you know, but the arrangements are made by other people. The first one, it was actually made by Gullin himself for a piano, I think. The mazurka. The next one was made by me and the most of them, but also Galium Verum was arranged by Daniel Tilling. The rest was arranged by me, and I stole a lot from Lars Gullin, of course, but I made a lot of it, and he made a lot of it. The next tune is called Be Careful, and that one is arranged by Lars Almqvist. That's the one who lives in Drag. And, well, here it is. Thank you. Thanks. As I told you, we met on a gig with this band, Maj-Lis Gullin, the wife of Lars Gullin. And we were wondering about this title. It's called Toka, Voka, Oka, Boka. It doesn't make any sense. It does some make some sense in Swedish, but not very much, and not at all in English. But we were told that it's about a book, that's a kind of tree, not a, I don't know, it's not called a book, I guess. Well, however, this tree, a bokträd, beech tree. Okay, beech tree. Well, it was filled with bees, not beast, the other thing, geting. Wasps, yeah, that's right. And it sounded crazy. The tree, Lars thought that the tree was crazy. That's the reason for the word tok, crazy in Swedish. Boka, I don't know about that. I don't know about oka either. But boka is because of the tree, of course. Well, this was very strange, I understand. Sorry very much, sorry. We're going to play it anyway. And it's arranged by Emily Jeremias.
Thank you.
I realized that we have played 1 hour. And we should play 1 hour and 10 minutes. We have to skip one tune. Does anyone have any suggestions? Should we play Iglo or Decent Eyes? Decent Eyes. Okay. Yes. Let's play Decent Eyes. Det är hyggliga ögon på svenska.
Thank you.
We have lots of tunes, actually, but we only have time to play one more. Yes, we will do that. And that's the most famous one. Maybe I should tell all the names again. We have Daniel Migdal. We have Henrik Nijmark Meyers. Ylva Lis Hiljakus. Sabina Sandri Olsson. Martin Sjöstedt. Daniel Fredriksson. Och Fredrik Lindborg, thank you very much. It's been a pleasure playing for you. We have a record, it's called A Swedish Portrait. It's for sale out there in the back and also on the internet. This is the most famous tune that Lars Gelin wrote. It's called Danny's Dream. Thank you. Thank you very much. It's been a pleasure being here. Thank you, Ystad Jazz Festival, for having us here. It's been a great pleasure. Thanks. I don't know, do we have time for an extra? Or I don't know if we got time for an extra. Do you want an extra? Okay, let's see. No, can someone who knows tell us if we can pay an extra? Now, no one in charge. Brian, do you know? Can we play an extra or is it okay? Okay, let's play one more then. I think that we should play, what do you think, baritonom or iglo? Baritonom. And har någon sett? And that's in English, has anyone seen? And it's about someone who lost their love and can't find it again.
Yeah.